I think blindness can be a really emotive and loaded term. You might imagine that everything's totally black, but of course there's a huge spectrum of visual impairment. Have you ever wondered if it might be possible one day to restore vision? One of the most common forms of visual impairment is if your vision looks a bit blurry because your lens is not focusing the light to quite the correct plane. In that case, we would use perhaps the oldest form of vision restoration technology that we've been using for hundreds of years. We would use eyeglasses. But not all vision problems are as easily solved as that. The research community is really working furiously to try to develop some of these new vision restoration therapies. So one of those approaches is using a little photosensitive chip. So light falls on the chip and it produces electrical stimulation, and you can surgically implant that under the retina to try to stimulate the remaining neurons and bring back some light perception. Another strategy is to try to make other cell types that still remain in the eye but are not light sensitive into kind of artificial photoreceptors that will detect light. And one way to do that is to take light sensitive proteins that are originally found in algae and express them instead in the eye. Lastly, there's a possibility of actually trying to replace the missing cells directly. So instead of using a chip or making other cell types light sensitive, maybe we could actually grow new photoreceptors in the lab and insert those into the eye and get those to connect back up with the remaining retinal neurons. So the interdisciplinary nature of vision research is integral to our ability to figure out new treatments. And one of the strengths of the University of Rochester is that we have a Center for Visual Science, which has folks from the Institute of Optics, as well as the Flaum Eye Institute and neuroscience, everyone working together. So we're really building on decades and decades of work, and truth, hundreds of years of work, to get to these kind of positions where we are able to now start to offer treatments for debilitating human diseases.